Aqui é óleo.
So-called spoon scoops were used to hollow out the inside. By hand was a really tough job, 2 to 3 hours for one pair. By machines nowadays, 5 minutes.
So
the machine will make the outside shape, works the same way as duplicating a key. We're gonna make a copy of the model. German machine for the outside, a French machine for the inside. They're both about 80 years old.
Pass up, Lee.
Yeah.
A podle toho to udělá obrázek.
Listen.
First of all, in making cheese, what do we need to make cheese?
Milk.
Obviously milk. And that's what we need to start off with. And that's what we do. In the morning, around 4 a.m., we pour the milk inside this container. And as you can see, there's these three blades that keep on stirring the milk. And that's very important for later. But the milk will get heated up to 29 degrees Celsius. And that is because of this liquid. And it's called rennet. And what is rennet? It's actually a bacteria taken out of the stomach of a cow.
Uh-huh.
And when you put this inside the milk will start to get really thick like a pudding. And because of the stirring, it will get divided into two parts. You get 90% of whey and then 10% of curds. And the whey you might know from whey powder or protein powder. Yeah, it's full of protein, so it's very nutritious. But that we don't need to make the cheese. We only need the 10% of curds.
Right.
And that's what we take. So you need about 10 liters of milk to make 1 kilogram of cheese. And this is a cheese form for 1 kilogram of cheese. As you can see, there's this net and little holes underneath. And we put the curd inside and press it for about 2 hours. And this is very important to make sure that the cheese is solid and that the excess of water will be pushed out. So afterwards, after those 2 hours, we take the cheese out of the form, and then we put it in a salt bath. And in the salt bath, there's about 20% of salt and 80% water. And the salt is very important for preservation, because back in the days we didn't have refrigerators, so we needed to make sure that it will stay good for a long time. And afterwards, it's also very nice for the flavor, the salty flavor. We take the cheese out of the salt bath after 24 hours. And then we put a layer of wax and then a layer of paraffin over it. And in the paraffin there are little holes, so that after and then you can use the cheese grater, the cheese slicer to make little slices. So who wants to try?
Quer provar, Beatriz? Vai lá.
That's for you. Watch out, it's very sharp.
That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna